It all starts with a dead girl. Ever since I was little, I've had this dream. It's the end of summer. A girl is running through the woods. The moon, the scent of pines. And then the gunshot. It always felt so real. The blood on my cheek, the cold sweat running down my skin. I'd managed to convince myself it really happened. This scar of a memory. A part of me I could never fully understand. Well, that wasn't the only part. No wonder people used to think I was strange. If they only knew. That day when the phone rang, it was the hardest day of my life. The day I went home to say goodbye to my father. Dress him up for his last journey. Put him in a suit, fix his tie. Simple. Just the things he did every day. But looking through his stuff wasn't easy. I needed a moment to pull myself together. I was almost ready. I just had to find his special tie clip. Shit.
Yeah. Nice to see you too. Jack's room. It's like he never... Damn it.
I used to think I'd never fit in. But Jack... He didn't mind my weirdness. He kept telling me I was special. I can't believe it's all still here. Oh, Jack. Huh. I guess I forgot about this one. I can do it now. Photo I took of you, Jack. Shit.
Looks nourishing.
Here you go. What's your face? Glad to see you're still kicking around. Right. The tie clip. Pull yourself together, Marianne. Jack's tie clip. I need to find it. Weird to be back in my old room. So many memories. I used to get a lot of these. To me, they were like trophies. Badges of honor for doing the right thing. Jack wasn't too amused, but he did his best to cover for me. I kind of feel bad for making him go through all that. My oldest family heirloom. As a kid, I'd show this to people just to freak them out. I'd usually say something like, "Pretty sick, huh?" I was such a dork. Kids from the orphanage. Not all of them had my luck. That's why I kept coming back. To play. To take care of them. To listen. That was the least I could do. Come on, Jack. Where'd you put it? Okay. Let's do this the other way. There you are. Keep hissing at me. Who do you think's gonna feed you now? We lived upstairs from Jack's funeral home. It wasn't as weird as it sounds. Besides, if it wasn't for that, I may never have learned to use my powers. Jack taught me to accept my condition. Of all my foster parents, he was the only one who saw it as a gift and not a curse. Jack's in the prep room. Oh, weird. I don't remember locking it. The key should be in the office. Here it is. Not sure if I'm ready for this. Hey, Jack. I got your special clip. No. Where's your tie? Snazzy. You wouldn't have it any other way. I didn't expect this to be easy. I guess I didn't know what to expect. When things get personal, it just burns you from the inside out. There. I guess you're ready. But am I? Oh, can't you people read? The sign says closed. You felt it too, huh? And then it happened, as it did so many times before. Just when I thought my day couldn't get any worse.
Oh, where is that darn notebook? I'm gonna be late. I need to find that. Marianne? Marianne, are you crying, my child?
It's fine, Jack.
Now, you didn't happen to see my notebook, did you, darling? My memory's a bit fuzzy. So much for aging gracefully.
Listen, Jack. You should probably get some rest. Forget the notebook.
Oh, no, no. I've got so much work, my dear.
It's okay, Jack.
No, I can't just...
What? Let it go. It's not important.
You are crying. What's wrong, dear? Why is it so cold in here? Where is that?
It's okay, Jack. It's okay.
My sweet little Marianne. What would I ever do without you?
Jack. Don't worry about it. It's time to get some rest.
Oh, Marianne.
Yeah?
Oh, I'm worried about the surgery. When I'm at the hospital, are you sure you're going to be all right?
Yes, Jack. It's going to be fine.
You know, I promised myself once I would never let anything happen to you. Not while I'm around.
I'll be fine. I promise.
No risky stuff, then. All right?
All right, Jack. Now, get some rest.
I need... Oh, yes. Be good, Marianne. I love you, my child. I've loved you since the moment you walked into my life. Remember that. Always.
Most people would give anything to have that opportunity. To say all the things that were left unsaid. But it didn't make things any easier. I could help 1,000 souls cross over, but when it came to Jack, it still hurt like hell.
I love you too, Daddy.
I used to think everyone saw the world the way I did. Divided, torn between two realities. But no, I was the only one. Or so I thought.
We're closed. There's another funeral home across town. I can give you the number.
Marianne.
Who is this?
You don't know me, Marianne. But I know you.
Look, if this is a joke...
You'd need to listen to me, Marianne.
Okay, I'm hanging up.
I know what you are.
What? Who is this?
My name is Thomas. I need your help.
Listen, if that's all you've got, I'm...
No, there's more. I can give you the answers you've been looking for your whole life. But I need you to trust me.
Trust you? I don't even know you.
It all starts with a dead girl.
What did you say?
The Nemo Resort. Find me there. Please. The light. It's almost gone. It's not dark yet, but it's getting there. You're the only one who can stop it. You're my only chance.
Hello? Hello? Shit. And off I went. On nothing but a hunch. A call from a complete stranger. But I'd learned to trust my instincts, and there was something about this guy, his voice. I felt like I should know him. Either way, he sure seemed to know me. The Neva Workers Resort. Right off the bat, I could feel there was something off about that place. Anyone home? I guess not. You want to keep me out, Neva? We're gonna have to do better than that. Not a whole lot of people knew about Neva. It used to be a government-owned vacation resort. Until one day it just stopped. And so an urban legend was born. The Neva Massacre. The details were always fuzzy. Crazed workers, ancient curses. You know, the usual. Hello. What's this? Be my way in. The split would come and go. If a place had a story to tell, well, I guess I was there to listen. place felt old and soaked in misery. Figures, I guess. 1,000 years of history doesn't just happen. It's paid for. But even in the deepest darkness, light can linger. Lonely, fragile, waiting for someone to embrace it. As I absorbed the energy, I wondered who it was that left it behind. A dying soldier whispering the name of his beloved? Or maybe just glad to be done with this world? Figured I could use it. Energy's energy, right?
Oh, so that worked. Good for you, Marianne.
These powers of mine, as much of a pain in the ass as they were, did come in handy sometimes. So there I was. Existing in two worlds, but never really living in either. The aura in that place. I've seen others like it, but never this intense. It was like a landfill of memories, emotions, and none of them good. Now, what's a fine machine like you doing in a place like this? Doubling as a spare bedroom, apparently. Hope you don't mind if I, pop your trunk. Not much here. Although, this could come in handy. Ow! Shit! What the hell? So began the great dumpster heist of 1999. I'm starting to get tired of your shit, Neva. You better be worth it. It's true. The Neva massacre. I need to find this Thomas guy and get the hell out of here.
Hello? Anyone? Thomas? You there? Hello? Thomas?
Easy, Marianne. It's just a good old-fashioned haunted hotel. Calm your ass down and answer the bell. Me. Yeah.
I did, didn't I? You look real scared. I'm Sadness.
Marianne. Sadness. Is that your name? I mean, you seem pretty cheerful to me.
Well, it's what I remember. My friends used to call me by a different name. But I don't remember what it was.
Your friends?
Oh, yeah. I used to have a lot of friends here. But they're all gone now.
Did something happen to them?
I don't really want to talk about it.
That's okay. So, do you live here? All by yourself?
You wouldn't believe how boring it gets sometimes.
I can imagine. This place must have been...
Oh, yes. So busy. People coming and going all the time. Always someone to play with.
Must have been nice.
It was. Not anymore.
So, tell me,
What happened?
I remember. People stopped coming. Only a few of them stayed. But they became very sad. Very angry. They might hurt you.
Thanks. But I can take care of myself. Hey, I was wondering, have you seen...
Marianne?
Yes?
Would you play with me? Just for a little while. It's been so long since I played with anyone.
Oh, okay, okay. But I need your help first.
Yes. Yes! Anything,
I'm
Marianne!
I'm looking for a man. Thomas. Do you know him?
Let me think. I've heard that name before. Somewhere.
Take your time.
Oh yeah. The second floor. We can look there. Come on. Hurry, Marianne.
Wait. I can't go that way. Somehow. Hey. Elevator. Might as well see if it works. Sadness. I wished I knew her real name. Okay, Marianne, just take a deep breath and... let go. Gotta move fast. An out-of-body experience. It's like taking a plunge into nothingness. Stay under for too long and it just pulls you in. Now get your ghostly ass back and power up that elevator. Uh-huh. Where did she go? What is that? Okay. Not getting through here. Shit. I didn't even know I could do that. Ah, gross. It looks like flesh.
Yes. I'm working on it. Yes, I know. Yes. I understand. Just give me some time. A few days. You'll get what you want.
Ugh. That voice. I don't know why, but it gives me shivers. Looks like the only way. Great. This room, it feels cold. Memories of grief, loneliness. Some objects soak up moments from the past. Just squeeze in the right spot and let it pour out.
Ah, sunflower, weary of time. For my favorite nurse.
Oh, Mr. Tarkovsky, you shouldn't have.
Please, it's the least I can do for all the good work you do around here.
Huh. An actual happy memory. So there's more to this place than just doom and gloom.
Useless old hag! Why would he care any more than the others?
It's more than grief. More than despair. This letter crushed her spirit. Shit, there are thousands of them. I'm gonna need more energy to get through. I'm in for another dive.
Oh, God. I hate this.
Disturbingly satisfying. This could be useful. The light of a memory strong enough to defy this place.
Want me to read you another one, darling? Oh, look at this mess! Don't worry, I'll clean you up in no time. I'm here for you, my love.
This man, Tarkovsky, he ended up as her patient?
You... I know you're there. Wish I had the strength to cut you out. You don't deserve to exist. You're nothing!
There have been times when I thought about ending it all. But I was too afraid that a part of me would go on, trapped on the other side. Forever.
Michael. Manager, huh?
Marianne!
Oh, Sadness. We gotta stop meeting like this.
I told you to follow me!
Take it easy, Sad. This place is huge. It's easy to get lost.
Just stick with me.
Okay. I'll stick like a tick.
You're funny.
This Thomas Rekovich.
What?
All right. Listen, hun. You said you remembered someone named Thomas. Was it Thomas Rekovich? Was he the manager here?
I guess.
You think he stuck around?
I'm not sure. There was an old man here, very recently, I think. Oh.
And you think it was Thomas?
Oh, I don't know. Old men all look the same, all wrinkly and old. Blah.
Hey, that's not very nice. Well, if he's still around, I've got an infestation to report.
Marianne! I feel... Oh, I don't think we should be here.
It's okay, Sadness. Look, there's no one... here. Sadness? It all hit me as soon as I entered the room. Anguish. Fear. Longing. What the hell happened here? It still works. Someone's been using it. Too small to fit a door. I could instantly tell there was more to that clock than met the eye. There we go. There. An imprint. Is that... Thomas? There! Looks like a passage. A spirit well. I could absorb some of that energy. As I moved the clock hand, I realized it was a junction between realities. It's rare, but I'd seen it before. Looks like I'm in for another dive. Someone tried real hard to keep this place a secret. Wonder what's in here on the other side. Let's see if it worked. Aha. Okay. Let's get the rest of me in there.
Never get used to this.
Nope. Doesn't work. Ugh. I hate to think what kind of photos need this much secrecy. Okay. I know how this works. I need 3 liquids to develop the photo. That's 1. 2 more to go. This should come in handy. That's all of them. Looks like there's a tray missing. Who's there? What the fuck is this?
Thank you. your strength. He's fucking...
Hello? Are you all right?
Don't look at me! Don't go!
Oh, God.
Don't leave me here. Alone!
Naked!
Let me saw you off.
Oh, God. No!
No more of you. Your team just up. It all ends in me. Wait. Don't go!
Oh, God.
Don't leave me here. Alone!
Naked!
Let me try you off.
Oh, God! No!
Don't worry. Be just fine.
Not a fan of light, huh? Fucking figures.
To really meet you.
Most people spend their whole lives seeing only a fraction of our reality. Lucky them. I have spent my whole life looking beyond the edges of our reality. Even as a child, I saw things that would break a grown man. Eventually, I grew into it. It became my normal. But that thing, it was anything but normal. I've never encountered anything like this. This ravenous. I felt lost. I came to Neva looking for answers, and all I got was more questions. What was that monster? Who was Thomas? And what did he want from me? I woke up with icy water in my veins. I wanted nothing but to get out of there. To just get up and run until my legs give out, until my lungs collapse. But I knew I couldn't. It wouldn't have solved anything. And besides, sadness needed my help. Is someone there?
Mary and Happy.
You're
okay.
Sadness? Is that you? Are you okay? What was that thing? Hello?
Find Richard.
Richard? No, Sadness. The man I'm looking for is named Thomas. Who's Richard?
It's on the day room.
Day room? Are you trying to show me the way? What now? First Thomas, then Richard. Before I knew it, I was looking for a bunch of strangers. At least Sadness was still with me, in a way. That? Oh God, it's everywhere. How many people died here? Thank you.
Hey, Marianne. You look like shit. Are those bolt cutters? Might be useful. If only I could reach them. Whoa! Sadness? How did you... Ah, shit!
Anyone? I'm sure they're here somewhere. No, no. Bernard wouldn't do that. He's nice. Ugh, she's talking to herself again. What a freak.
Hey, don't talk about her like that.
In here. This isn't funny.
I really don't think we should.
Shut the heck up, Bernard. Guys!
Ugh. Kids can be such assholes sometimes.
Cover your nose. Try not to look at them. The sooner we're done, the sooner we can get out of this place.
Ugh. Definitely didn't need to feel that. What is it? You want to show me something? What the hell? Snowdrop, huh? Why does that sound familiar? Oh. As I got closer to the mirror, I felt a slight tug in my pocket. I could tell there was more to that figurine than just carved wood. I can feel it calling out to me. It was the first time that it ever happened. I touched the mirror and crossed over to the other side. What the hell is this place? Where those bolt cutters are. So close, and yet so in a different reality. A spirit well. I could use some of that energy. All these people, they weren't just killed. Their spirits were ripped. Broken beyond repair. Burn, you little fucks. That figurine was the key. I can't pass through without it. Wait. I know you. You were that boy. Bernard, was it? This was yours, wasn't it, Bernard? It's about time you got it back.
I'm sorry you had to go through all this. It's time for you to find peace. Bernard.
Thank you.
Huh. It kind of looks like the one I used to get through the mirror. Feels like it, too.
They always do! Stay with me!
Shit, please.
Stay!
Between worlds. There was no escaping it. Great. Another mirror. Oh God.
What now?
Oh no, there's more of them. What has it done to you? Just like Bernard.
No! What are you? Stop!
This is it. This is where he died. Okay? I still need his name. If only I could see the other side of this place. Huh. Some sort of a conference room. Attendance list. I'll bet the name I'm looking for is here on this page. But which one is it?
I can't believe they sat me across from Boris. I don't care whose nephew he is. He's just a sexist pig for all I care. And late, as always.
That voice. That's the guy. Boris. That's the guy he was talking about. Seat number 9. Okay. So this is Boris's seat. So the one I'm looking for is... This is it. The man I'm looking for. This is where he died. That's it. Nicholas. Okay, Nick. Let's get you out of here. get some rest. You've earned it, Nicholas.
Thank you, madam.
Okay. One down, one to go. Better get to it. Locked. There we go.
You up, just like the others. together soon. In me. It all ends in me.
I'm getting close. That woman was here. Oh. She was a ballerina? Nice card. Was Vivienne one of your stars?
Okay, last one. I can barely feel my wrist. I don't care. I just want to go to bed. I need to be alone.
There. That's her room. Someone couldn't even let her have her privacy. This is where it happened. Of all the places.
You? What are you? No! Get out! Ah! No!
No, not pleasant. Not pleasant at all. And still no name. There's gotta be something. Okay. Let's find out who you really were, Vivienne. Huh. The page was torn out. I can't make out the numbers. Partial numbers. There. A bunch of numbers, some would say. But I sensed there was a lot more to them.
Oh my God, Ellie! I thought you were... No, I'm really happy to hear from you. Why didn't you call sooner? You did? But... Eugene, that slippery son of a bitch.
Ellie... She was very special to her. You don't need to be a medium to see it. You called the other one Ellie when you were talking on the phone, so... Tori! It's you! The real you. That's your name. It made sense, really. A name is more than what everyone calls you. It's what you feel yourself to be. Not gonna lie, it felt good, putting that curse of mine to good use. Moments like that used to keep me going. Now, I'm not sure anymore.
You can be free now, Tori.
Thank you. Thank you.
You did it, Marianne. Sent them away. To a better place, I hope. Well, anywhere is better than here. Will you just let me pick you up already? Finally. Time to get back to the day room. This place. This is where it started. So worth it. I love you, bolt cutters. Kinda sounds like a spy name. Cutters. Bolt cutters. Or a movie star, like in a movie you don't use your real name for. Yeah. Spy name it is. Okay, Marianne. Let's see what Sadness wanted me to see. I hope she's all right. All right. Here we go. Thank God.
You're all right. I was so worried.
Oh, yeah. That thing almost got me. What the hell is it?
It came from shame. From helplessness. From rage.
Rage?
It's like anger, but more. Once it got out, we couldn't stop it. It ate all of them, Marianne. All of my friends.
Your friends?
I'm the only one left.
It's okay, Sadness. I'm here now.
No, no. It'll eat you too. Just like the others.
I won't let it hurt you, I promise. Why don't you tell me something about this place?
It's the day room. We used to play here.
With Richard? Is he one of your friends?
No. But he was smart.
That's smart. Wait, is he...
A bad thing happened to him. I remember he became hollow, like a puppet. He... I don't want to see him.
What? Why not? What do you remember?
No. Don't tell them.
Don't tell anyone. You don't have to tell me. But you should still come with me so that I can keep you safe.
No. No, Marianne.
The sadness.
No, never again.
Why did you bring me here? It was then I realized there was something she wanted me to see. With my own eyes. Richard? Are you there? This place is packed with memories. Bad ones. Guilt. Humiliation. Rage. Show me a way out of here.
I love this melody. It reminds me of my childhood. At least the good parts of it.
But the bad parts, they're always there, aren't they?
You're a very smart girl, Lily. You know that, don't you? You're special.
Her voice, is that sadness? Aha! Sheet of music. Well, at least part of it.
Locked.
Be all the pieces of the score now.
Thank you.
Oh, Richard! My arms are getting tired. You've been drawing me for hours.
Almost done. You know, Lily, you remind me of someone. A girl I knew when I was very young.
Did you love her?
Yes. With a young, innocent love, free of the ferocity of adult lives.
Richard. I'm getting a weird vibe from him. There's grief, sorrow, and something else.
Aren't you a bit old to be playing with dolls? Here, I bought it especially for you.
Oh, a ribbon? It's beautiful. Thank you, Uncle Richard.
Here, let me... On the other hand, why don't you do it yourself?
What was that? It's like something stirred inside him.
No! I didn't mean to... Oh, God! What have I done?
It feels... cold. What have you done? I had never felt anything so desperate. It was calling out to me. It wanted to show me something.
Damn it! Thought I could protect her. Idiot! What would you think of me? I failed you. I failed us. It's all falling apart. What? Yes, I know. No, I need to be sure. There's gotta be something around here. You want what? Fuck! Look who finally decided to let me out of my cage. And only when you need my help. Surprise. Surprise.
You know what? I'm not in the mood. Just tell me what you see. Come on. Come on.
Yes. I can feel it.
Okay.
It's around here. Somewhere.
Oh, well, It's real fucking specific.
Hey, I'm trying to help here.
You know, sometimes I wonder.
Well, it doesn't make it easier when you keep me in the dark for so long.
Oh, Christ.
Thanks for that, by the way. Hell of a way to treat your soulmate.
God damn it! There's nothing here!
There is.
Really?
I'm never wrong about these things. You know that.
Well, screw this. I should have known better than to listen to you. Wait. What? There. There. Where? What?
You building tension? Grab the fucking thing!
Would you shut up? He's obsessed. What is he? What have I done?
We couldn't have known.
I let him into my home. He was like a father to me. Fucking bastard! Who could he?
I told you we couldn't trust anyone but ourselves. Keep it together. Think. What do we do now?
We wait. And when he comes back, I'll just...
Whoa. Easy, Tiger. Remember what's at stake here. Just let me do what I do.
You better do it fast. Because if you don't, I will kill him.
Thomas, I wasn't expecting you. Is everything all right, my friend?
Did you do it, friend?
Did I? What?
My daughter. My 13-year-old daughter. I entrusted her to you.
Thomas.
Did you do it?
I don't.
I found the sketchbook. Forced myself to look through it. Cover to cover. Every single fucking page! Tell me you didn't hurt her.
Thomas, please.
Tell me I'm wrong, Richard. Tell me, and I'll let you go.
It wasn't me. Thomas, you have to understand. There's a sting inside of me.
Shut up.
You have to believe me. I wanted to die.
We'll make it quick.
Thomas, I'm so sorry.
She's my daughter!
I never wanted any of this. I should never have come here.
But you did. Knowing what she means to me.
Thomas, I swear, I'll go away. You'll never... Wait, but you... No, let me out. Let me out.
Let me in. Time to cut it out.